Hello everyone, welcome back to Chinda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet off shoulder top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this top, it is really stretching, so it's easy to wear. And in this video, I also showing you how to make the top bigger and longer for any size. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the bust part. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 36, it is equal 7 inches. For this top, we are working on the length way. So for the foundation chain, it is the height of the top. If you guys want your top longer, please add more chains. And for this blue yarn, it is just a sample showing you how to make the lemon peel stitch. Like I said, if you guys want your top longer, please add more chains. After you got your desired fit, next we are going to make the lemon peel stitch. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the next chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, next we are going to make the double crochet into the next chain. To make the double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. For making lemon peel stitch, we are going to keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every chain until the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row of the lemon peel stitch looks like. So for the last stitch of my first row, it's end with a double crochet. So next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to start with a single crochet. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make double crochet into the single crochet stitch. Remember, under the single crochet stitch must be a double crochet stitch, and under the double crochet stitch must be a single crochet. So keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. after you reach the end of the row, and this is what the second row looks like. So for the last stitch of my second row is end with a double crochet. So for row 3, we are going to start with a single crochet. If your last row end with a single crochet, you have to start with a double crochet. Keep repeating this until you reach row 97. It is equal 26 inches. This is the measurement around my bust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more rows. After you reach row 97, next we are going to connect these both sides together. Continue from where your last stitch is, and we are going to make slip stitch. Continue insert the hook into the other side's loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loop. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet both sides together, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loops. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all two loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the wrong side of the stitch looks like. Turn your top right side out, and this is what the right side looks like. Next, continue from where your last stitch is, and we are going to make single crochet around this edge. Chain one, and single crochet into the next stitch. Then make another single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made two single crochet, then skip one stitch and make single crochet into the next stitch. Keep repeating this by make two single crochet and skip one stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, we are going to make the lace stitch or the shell stitch around the edge. Continue from where your last stitch is and chain 1. Then make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 2. After you got 2 chains, then skip 3 stitches. And we are going to make the bulk crochet 3 together into the 4th stitch. To make the bulk crochet 3 together, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then keep repeating this into the same stitch for 2 more times. After you got 3 double crochet in the same loop and 4 loops on your hook, then yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. And this is how we made the double crochet 3 together. Then continue make 3 chains. After you got 3 chains, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first chain. You must have 2 loops on your hook like this and yarn over, pull through all the loops. Next, chain 1, and we are going to repeat the same thing into the loop for 2 more times. It means that we are going to make the bulk crochet 3 together with a picot stitch for 2 more times in the same loop. And now you must have 3 groups of the bulk crochet stitch in the same loop, as you can see. Then continue make 2 chains. And skip 3 stitches. And we are going to repeat the same thing like the first stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. for the last stitch, after you have made 2 chains, then skip 3 stitches and make single crochet into the 4th stitch. After you have made single crochet, then make slip stitch into the next stitch. And next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the back part of the top looks like. And this is what the front part of the top looks like. Next, we are going to make single crochet around this edge by repeat the same thing like we did at the bottom edge. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Then make 2 single crochet and then skip 1 stitch and keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row and make slip stitch. And this is what my top looks like. As you can see, this slip stitch seam is on the middle part of the top. Next, please try the top on your body. And then use stitch marker to mark at the front the underarm part and also the back part of the underarm as you can see in this picture. And repeat the same thing to the other side. And then you can count the number of the stitches between this stitch marker to make sure that it has the same measurement. If it's not equal, you can move the stitch marker to make it equal. Next, we are going to make off-shoulder sleeves. To begin, attach the yarn into the first stitch marker. And then make 30 chains. If you guys want your sleeve bigger, you can add more chains. After you got 30 chains, then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the second stitch marker. Make sure that your foundation chain doesn't twist. Remove stitch marker and then make slip stitch. For my upper arm circumference, it is equal 9 inches. It is measuring from the 30 chains and include the underarm space as you can see. Next, turn your work. And we are going to make single crochet into this underarm space. Keep making single crochet into every stitch until you reach the corner, then we meet you back again. After you reach the corner, then continue make single crochet into this back part of the foundation chain. Keep making single crochet into every chain until you reach the other corner or until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Remember, make sure that you're working on the lower part of the foundation chains. after you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, next for row 1, chain 1, turn your work. And we are going to make increase by make 1 single crochet and 1 double crochet into the same stitch. After you had 1 single crochet and 1 double crochet into the same stitch, then keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row 2 until row 13, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make lemon peel stitch by keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. So start from row 2 until row 13, we are not make increase, just make normal stitch. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 13. For the measurement from row 1 until row 13, it is equal 3.5 inches. If you guys want the sleeve longer, please add more rows. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 14, chain 1, and we are going to make single crochet 3 together. To make single crochet 3 together, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. And continue insert the hook into the next loop, and now you must have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. And this is how we make single crochet 3 together. Keep repeating this into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. You can make decrease by making single crochet 2 together if you think it's too tight around your arm. after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 15, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Make sure that you make single crochet a little bit loose. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 16, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the sleeve looks like. And this is what the underarm part looks like. Next, we are going to make single crochet at the top part of the sleeve. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner of the sleeves. And chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch from the other corner, then I will meet you back again. After you have one last stitch, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch and make single crochet into every stitch until you have two last stitches from the corner. Then I will meet you back again. After you have two last stitches, then make slip stitch into the next two stitches. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch and make single crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch from the corner, then make slip stitch. After you reach the corner, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the darning needle to weave in. And now your first sleeve is done. For the second sleeve, please repeat the same thing like the first sleeve. Next, we are going to make the strap. Fold your top into two pieces like this and use stitch marker to mark at the front middle part of the top. Next, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. and then make 62 chains. It is equal 13 inches. If you guys want the strap longer, please add more chains. After you got 62 chains, count 12 stitches away from the slip stitch seam and your stitch marker to make at the 12th stitch and repeat the same thing to the other side. Next, we are going to connect these foundation chains into the right side of the stitch marker by make slip stitch, remove stitch marker and then make slip stitch. Then make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to continue make slip stitch into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, and this is what the first strap looks like. Next, we are going to make the second strap by continue make 62 chains. It is equal 13 inches. It is the same number like the first strap. After you got 62 chains, then continue make slip stitch into the left side of the stitch marker. After you have made slip stitch, then make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made single crochet, then continue make slip stitch into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch. And chain 1, cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle dot to weave in. And now your off shoulder top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye. So this is in case that you want to know how I'm wearing this.